to walk and the blind to see. Opens prison doors, sets the captives free. I've got a river of life flowing out of me. Spring up, oh well, within my soul. Spring up, oh well, and make me whole. Spring up, oh well, and give to me that life abundantly. I've got a river of life flowing out of me. Makes the lame to walk. Prison doors sets the captives free. I've got a river of life flowing out of me. Spring up, oh well, within my soul. Spring up, oh well, and make me whole. Spring up, oh well, and give to me that life abundantly.
Spring up, oh well, within my soul.
Raise up that well in us, Lord God.
Thank you.
for the Lord God Almighty reigns. Alleluia. Alleluia. For the Lord God Almighty reigns. Alleluia. The Lord God Almighty reigns. the praise. Worthy is your name. Worthy is your name, Jesus. You deserve the praise. Worthy is your name.
Oh, we worship you here today, Lord. You're worthy of our praise. Oh, how we love you, Lord.
You deserve the praise. Worthy is your name. Worthy is your name, Jesus. You deserve the praise.
Sometimes we can fill in our own words to a song, make it more personal. We can just flow out of our heart our praise for the Lord. We don't have to follow the set words that are on the wall. We can sing from our hearts and tell Jesus how much we love him. We can have that freedom.
Oh, we love you, Lord. You up in this place, oh Lord.
Thank you,
Jesus. Oh, you're worthy, Lord. We glorify your name. Mighty God.
Lord, you deserve the praise.
Yeah.
This place, Lord. Fill our hearts. Fill our lives. We need your Holy Spirit reign. Fill us up, Lord, with springs of living water overflowing in our lives, oh God.
I want to share,
praise you, Lord.
You know, I was doing my devotions, and, you know, on Sunday nights, I've been sharing a lot about in the book of Numbers and how I'm getting inspired by that book. Believe it or not, okay? A lot of people, the minute I say Numbers, I see everybody look at me, oh, no, here we go, you know? It's one of those books, right? Nobody wants to hear about that. But I've been getting really blessed in the book of Numbers. I really have. To a point, you know, like in my devotional time this week, again, there was a verse that really popped at me, and I'm going to look at that in a minute. But I want to, what I want to share first is a few verses in 1 Corinthians chapter 10. I'm going to start with that. And I want to look at, you know, I'm going to just read a few verses here, starting with verse 1. And it says, "For I do not want you to be unaware, brethren," and some versions say ignorant on that part. "I don't want you to be unaware, brethren, that our fathers were under the cloud and all passing through the sea. And all were baptized into Moses in the cloud of the sea. And all ate the same spiritual food. All drank the same spiritual drink. For they were drinking from a spiritual rock, which followed them, and the rock was Christ." And Paul keeps writing about some of the things, you know, how they got tried and tested in the wilderness, but the rock was Christ. And you know, when they were wandering in the wilderness, the whole thing was to point us to Jesus. The whole thing, to show us that we needed to be dependent on the Lord, okay? And you know, that's the whole wandering thing was all about that, okay? And I don't know, but I don't know, I got a pretty thick head sometimes. Takes me a while to get it. And, well, it took them 40 years to get it. How God was going to be their provision for everything, you know? And, you know, we go through stuff, right, don't we, in life? And we need to remember that Jesus is everything we need. And he shows us that in the wanderings, okay? And like, I really got blessed. And I'm going to share you the verse that I got blessed with, okay? It's one of these verses that just popped out of nowhere. It's like, wow, this is really good, Lord. I think I want to talk about this. And so I want to start with Numbers chapter 21. That's where I want to go. Now, the thing is, well, before I say all of that, I'm going to read what popped out at me. I'm going to start with starting in verse 10, we see all the way down, they start moving around in the wilderness again. They left Kadesh Barnea, and that was the place that they sent the spies. That was like their base camp in the wilderness, okay? Well, they finally leave there after Marian dies, okay? They finally leave, but God's going to lead them in a new direction now. And in that direction, it's going to be on the east side of the Jordan River, on the opposite side of the Dead Sea. Can you do that? You got to figure it out? No? Maybe not? And we don't need to put that up. That's fine. And there it is. Okay. So I want to show you for a second, real fast. See, I put this in here, okay? And
And really, this is Kadesh Barnea here. And what we're going to be looking at today is they made a new journey. Instead of going around in circles, after Miriam and Aaron died, okay, because Aaron died after Moses struck the rock twice, and he got frustrated, and he lost the promised land, while him and Moses both can't get the promised land, Aaron either. So he died, but it was year 40. They wandered around for 40 years. Now, God is about ready to send them somewhere else, and we're going to be looking at that, and they sent them on this side of the Jordan River. See where Jericho is? They're about ready to go into Jericho, really. But God's setting them up, and they're going in this direction now. They're actually facing enemies now, okay? They're facing enemies. God's been protecting them for 40 years with that. Now they're facing enemies to take the land, okay? And what I circled over here, and you're going to see the verse that popped at me is right there, okay? All right, thank you, Brenda. And we'll get back to this. So in verse 10, it says all the places that they moved after Miriam died, okay? But I want to start with verse 14, okay? And it'll lead you to wonder what the Book of Wars is, okay? And they never found that book, but it's mentioned in the Bible, okay? So they're quoting out of that book, and that book can't be found anywhere. But it says this, "Wherefore it said in the Book of Wars of the Lord, Waheb in Suppa, and Wadis of Arnon, and the slope of Wadis extends to the site of Ar, okay, and leans the border of Moab." Now, from there, okay, and I titled my thoughts today, okay, "Singing in Beer." Okay? Or at beer. And from there they continued to beer. See that? That is the well. So the word beer means well. It's not beer like we know beer to be. It's a well. And at the well, the Lord said to Moses, "Assemble the people that I may give them water." And Israel sang this song. "Spring up, O well." We sang about it, didn't we? "Sing to it, the well which the leaders sank, which the nobles of the people dug, with the scepter and their staffs. And from the wilderness they continued to Matna," and then it continues, and they ended up, okay, so that place I had circled that was a brook, there was a place there, and I circled it. That river, Arnon, okay, was the border of Moab, and north of that is going to be when they allotted all the land to Israel. That's where Manasseh and Ephraim were going to get their land. So that river was the border of the new Israel about ready to happen, okay? The new land. That was the border. But over here, okay, God tells Moses, he tells them, "You go to that well, and you're going to get water." Now, this is the first time that the people of Israel did not complain they didn't have water. It's the first time. Every other time they would complain, oh, we got no water to drink, we got no food, we got no bread, we got no this, we got no that. But this is the first time, okay, they didn't complain. You know what they did? They sang. That's the first time. The other times when they complain, you know, Moses struck the rock and the water came out, and then they complained again. And not too long before that, okay, they complained again. In chapter 20, it talks about that. They complain. This is what they said. There's no water for the congregation. They assembled themselves against Moses and Aaron, and the people contended with Moses and spoke, saying, if only we had perished when our brothers perished before the Lord. So here's Moses. He got frustrated, right? And God told him, you speak to the rock, and water will come out. And he got so frustrated, he struck the rock twice. And he lost the promised land because of that. Because, you know, he was sick of the complaining. And, you know, God wants us, you know, like in our life. You know, when Moses told them at that well and they started singing, instead of complaining, it took 40 years for them to get it, okay? And a whole lot of plagues along the way, because, you know, there were a lot of things that happened. The fiery serpents happened when they complained. There were a whole bunch of things that happened. It took a lot, you know, hey, we're knuckleheads sometimes, aren't we? It takes a while for us to get it. Well, this time here, instead of complaining, okay, they sang a song. They sang. And they didn't even have the water yet. Okay? And that's faith right there. Now, Moses wasn't even involved in that miracle. He wasn't involved. His staff and his rod wasn't involved. And now 40 years have gone by, and like I showed you on the map, they're getting ready to cross the Jordan to go into the promised land, okay? It's 40 years now. And God is bringing them into a place of transition, that not everything is going to be handed to you all the time. It's not going to be handed to you like I've been doing. Now, you're going to have to do something on your own. And he told the leaders, you dig that well with your staffs. That's all they had. I couldn't imagine, like a staff, I think of a little crook thing. And I don't know, but I can't imagine, I can't get very far digging a hole with that. But I don't think it really had much to do with what they were using as much as the faith that they were exercising. And they weren't complaining this time. See, sometimes, you know, and I preached about Paul last week. And I was preaching when Paul was in prison with Silas, and how they were under arrest, and they got whipped, and they got beaten. And I was talking about that there's power in praise and prayer, right? Well, these people are starting to understand who their provision is. It's not Moses. It's the Lord. And they sang because they knew if God told Moses to tell them, okay? And after a while, like in the New Testament, we don't have to go through even Moses anymore. We got the Holy Spirit, don't we? So if God told Moses to tell them to dig a hole, this time here they did it. And and they weren't complaining. Now, in that journey, like I showed you, they had to go all the way around Edom because Edom wouldn't let them in their land. So they and I was in Israel, and that I didn't go that far out where, on the east of the Jordan, but that terrain, there's a lot of desert there, and it's really hot. It's really hot, and the loose sand and the loose rocks and all the critters that are around in that heat, right? And isn't it any wonder why they could get impatient and discouraged on their journey? Do we get impatient and discouraged in our journey? Are we living in a wilderness? We're not in heaven yet, right? We're living in a sin-cursed world, aren't we? But God wants to show us that He's our provision for everything. He's what we need. And these people are getting it, okay? Moses, you're telling me to dig this hole? Well, we're going to dig, and we're going to dig singing like we already have the water. They're not complaining. They're singing by faith. You know? And now, okay, like in the New Testament, where the, you know, the serpent, when they complain and God sent the fiery serpents and they put up, you know, the post with the serpent up, you know, and they had to look at it and they got healed, right? That was like pointing to the cross, to Jesus, that He's going to heal us from all the fiery darts of the enemy, right, that wants to kill us. And Jesus also said, I am the bread of life. Manna came from heaven, but now I am the bread of life. I am the manna from heaven. And then He tells us, okay, in John chapter 7, and I want to read this because it's important in what I'm saying, okay? Jesus wanted to show that He was also our water source. How long do you think we can live without water? 3 days? Well, we need the living water to keep us in victory, right? And sometimes, you know, sometimes we need to keep that well flowing. We could stop up that well when we're not praying and praising, can we? But Jesus said this, verse 36, 7:36. I'll start with 37. Now on the last day, the great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried out, saying, if any man is thirsty, let him come to me and drink. And I don't know, but life in this wilderness that we live in right now, we can end up thirsty and in want and in need, right? But Jesus tells us to come to Him and drink. It says, he who believes in me, as the scripture said, from his innermost being shall flow rivers of living water. Rivers of living water. He spoke this of the Spirit, of whom he also believed in him, were to receive, for the Spirit was not yet given because Jesus was not yet glorified. So after the cross, what happened? He went home to be with the Father, and the promise of the Holy Spirit came on this earth. And we got the Holy Spirit, don't we? So, what I need to say is, no matter what we face in this wilderness, okay? Now, some of us, we need to redig the well. Because that's where the life source is. And a lot of times, we can lean on a lot of other things than the Spirit of God, okay? Like, I was just doing something not long ago. Because the Bible says that the Holy Spirit, it knows the deep things of God, okay? And deep cries out to deep. And we got to dig deep sometimes to get what we need from the Lord. You know what I'm saying? And sometimes we got to get the dirt out of our well. What little we have in our life, we got to get that dirt out. And some of us that have the dirt out, okay? Well, we need to sing because God is going to give us what we need in this wilderness that we're in. It's the Holy Spirit that's going to give us victory. It's Jesus that's going to give us victory. We need to sing, you know? Like that song we were singing earlier, I was looking at the words to that. And it says, I've got a river of life flowing out of me. Makes the lame to walk and the blind to see. So you know what? The Holy Spirit can bring healing, can bring life, can set people free, opens prison doors, sets the captives free. I've got a river of life flowing out of me. Spring up, oh well, within my soul. Spring up, oh well, and make me whole. Oh well, and give to me that life abundantly. How many of us know that Jesus wants us to have abundant life? And he's given us a well. He's given us a well to draw from so that we can have victory. Victory over the wilderness that we're in, over the enemies that we face, the battles that we have, right? Jesus given us the bread of life to feed on, which is him, the Word of God. And he's also given us the Holy Spirit. So that we can have victory. And I feel like the people of Israel were starting to get it. After 40 years, okay? That's the first time they didn't complain that they didn't have water. They sang because they knew God was going to provide the water. And you know, that was the other time. The other time that they were singing in the book of, you know, during their wandering. Do you know what it was? 40 years before that, when they crossed the Red Sea and Marion had the tambourine. The horse and rider are in the sea, right? But for 40 years, they weren't singing. They did a lot of complaining, but they didn't sing.
Now they're ready to go into the promised land because they're trusting in the Lord. You know what I'm saying? God is going to be my water supply. God is going to be my food supply. God is going to fight my battles for me. God is going to be what I need. See, and God wants us to go in giant land. He doesn't want us to wander around in our wilderness of life. He wants us to have victory, don't he? And he's given us what we need to have that victory. The bread of life. The brazen serpent. Right? The cross. It's all Jesus. And Jesus, the Father sent the promise of the Holy Spirit to us. And I was sharing a little while ago, I didn't know what to do in the situation I was in, and I started praying in the Spirit, okay? I started praying in the Spirit, and the Holy Spirit, okay, gave me wisdom as to what to do in that situation. And I could have been very frustrated, and I could have been complaining, but the Lord gave me direction. See, the Holy Spirit is that living water flowing out of our inward being. And God wants that to flow out of us. He really does. He wants it to flow. And he wants us to have victory. And I'm just going to wrap it up with this. Right after they... You know, they sang a song, God provided their well. This time here they had to work for it a little bit. See, God's about ready to do a new thing, right? And now we got something better than that. We got the Holy Ghost. But the next, from verse 21 of chapter 21, it records that they got two victories over their enemies. Right after that. See, when you get strengthened by waters of a hidden well, we're going to live a life of continued victory. And this is exactly what happened with them. See, when we tap into that source, when we tap into the source of Jesus and the power of the Holy Spirit, okay, and the Word of God and prayer, and that's why we praise him, because you know what? He's going to show up in our life. And look, verse 21. They went against the Amorites. The Amorites wouldn't let them pass through, and they ended up destroying that whole nation. And then in verse 33, the nation of Bashan, and Og was the king. Well, they also got victory there. See, because they got refreshed at the water. And they had what they needed to do battle. Okay? And we have that. We get something better than that. We don't have to go, okay, all the way to Israel, right? By that river I showed you in a circle, okay? The only thing we need to do is to lean on Jesus and the power of the Holy Spirit. And he wants to give us victory and life abundantly. And I want that. How about you? I really want that. You know, God wants us to sing at beer. Don't he? And you know, it's easy to sing when we get the blessing. It's when we sing before the blessing comes.
like I preached last week, right? Because when we're singing before the blessing comes, what happens? What are we looking at? We're looking at the Lord to be what we need in our situation, right? We're actually singing a victory song when we do that. Now I'm going to end with this. Psalm 95. And then I'm going to say a prayer. And I hope you guys all enjoy the 4th of July. And hopefully it doesn't rain on our parade. But Psalm 95, and I'm going to read the whole thing because it really applies, okay? It's going to speak for itself, really. And it really applies to what I'm talking about, okay? It says, "Oh, come, let us sing for joy to the Lord. Let us shout joyfully to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving." I wonder if this is one of the songs at the well. "Let us shout joyfully to him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods, in whose hands are the depths of the earth. The peaks and the mountains are his also. The sea is his. For it is he who made it, and his hands formed the dry land. Come, let us worship and bow down and kneel before the Lord our Maker, for he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand." And Jesus is the good shepherd, ain't he? He's the good shepherd. He's going to take care of us sheep. He will. "Today, if you hear his voice, don't harden your hearts as in Meribah or as in the day of Massah in the wilderness when your fathers tested me. They tried me, though they had seen my work. For 40 years I loathed that generation and said they are a people who err in their heart. They do not know my ways. Therefore I swore in my anger, truly they will not enter my rest." And God's ways are different than our ways, right? Lean not on our own understanding. In all our ways, we need to acknowledge God, right? And he's going to direct our paths. He will. And you know what? He's going to give us rest. I honestly believe when they were digging that well, even though they didn't have water, they were walking in the rest and the peace of the Lord, because they knew that the Lord was going to give them water, right? So there's no need of us to be in turmoil. Whatever it is we're going through in life, God is he's the good shepherd. And all he wants us to do is kneel down before the good shepherd in the pasture he's providing us, right? He's going to take care of us, every one of us. And I'm going to say a prayer. Father, I want to thank you for today. I want to thank you for your word. I want to thank you for the reminder that you're our provision. You're our bread. You are our water source. You take care of all of our needs. And it's the goodness of God that we're living in, the goodness of God. You're so good to us, oh God. And we don't deserve it. We really don't, but you're so good to us. And help us, Lord. Help us to learn to just trust in you, no matter what it is that we're going through in our life, Father, because you're going to give us victory. You're going to give us life abundantly, oh God. And I pray that you meet every single need that is represented here today. And you touch every heart and every concern and every single obstacle that we feel is an obstacle, God. But you're God of everything. And we just want to bow down and worship you, oh God. Because you're God. You're God. And I just want to thank you, God, that you've equipped us with the Word of God, the Holy Spirit, prayer, praise, one another, a place to come to church to encourage each other. I want to thank you for the things you bless us with, God. You know what we need even before we ask. We don't need to be complaining. You already know what we need. You know. And help us just to praise you, even if we don't see the answer to our prayer. Help us to step out in faith and just trust you, God. And I pray for your blessing and help us to be a blessing to others, oh God. Thank you, Jesus. What do you have?